Viewer discretion advised. No, seriously.
Ice cream truck! I can hear it.
Ice cream truck. Do, 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 do. Vanilla ice cream truck.
What the fuck is a vanilla ice cream truck?
It's a very plain Jane truck.
Does it taste like vanilla ice cream?
Do they, what kind of flavors do they have? Just Neapolitan and that's it?
Yeah,
we have vanilla
it's
and vanilla
bean. Strawberry and chocolate, and then they have Neapolitan, but they charge you extra.
No,
so you can get one scoop of each, or you can get one scoop of the Neapolitan, and they cost the same price.
Yeah.
It's like, well, we have vanilla bean,
yes.
We have vanilla extract, it's different than regular vanilla.
Vanilla extract smells delicious.
We have French vanilla.
But it tastes awful.
Hey, we have French vanilla.
Oh yeah, I forgot about French vanilla.
The guy in the truck
goes, "Oh, I forgot we have French vanilla."
We have hand churned vanilla, and we have slow churned vanilla, and then we have machine churned vanilla.
Mad Bull.
You're like, I don't know what all these.
We have vanilla ice cream soup. Yo, like that's just melted ice cream.
Yo, we should definitely. Yo, we should definitely go get ice cream.
Nah.
At eight, it's half price.
Nah.
At Sonic,
maybe.
And I'm paying.
Isn't that their...
Okay.
Isn't that just their milkshakes?
All their shakes. All their ice cream.
Oh, I thought it was just milkshakes. I didn't think it was ice cream.
You know what's worse about getting shakes from Sonic?
Mm. What?
Is who the fuck puts all those ingredients in our goddamn ice cream?
Mad Bull.
I don't know, but you should get a
Oreos,
44.
Reese's Pieces, Snickers, Heath bars. Who the fuck eats a Heath bar?
I recommend everybody get a Route 44 milkshake.
I don't even know what a Heath bar is.
Keep going.
Mad Bull 34, episode 2. I don't know what it's called.
Hey, we'll never get through all these.
It's about a cat. That's fine. It's about cops.
Cats.
Mean streets of New York.
It's about cats.
Defending.
Shoot people.
Defending the American way of police brutality.
Yep. Remember, if somebody shoots at you, you have the right to just blow them away.
So what happened in episode 1, Nick?
Rape.
Somebody got blown away.
Okay, so there wasn't actually a rape that we saw.
Well.
There's a couple attempted rapes.
I mean, the chick that got blown up, I'm pretty sure that he had his way with her before.
But we didn't
see
it.
Nope, we did not.
All we saw was consensual and then attempted unconsensual.
And we saw some BDSM.
A little bit.
And some drowning.
Yeah, that happened. Yeah, she wasn't into that.
For all we know, he was screwing her while drowning because he was naked.
Yeah.
Maybe he just liked being naked.
It's true. Episode 2.
So, 90s.
I was about to say, 90s was weird. Look at that fucking carrot.
A carrot with a tooth.
I don't know what the fuck I'm looking at.
They're
right
on top
now.
Of their game.
This is back when the 90s were trying to define themselves, except they couldn't get out of the 80s.
Oh no, they still couldn't get out of them under umbrella pants. Huh? Parachute pants. There you go.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. Pigs ain't gonna get him.
Oink.
Until Mad Bull gets on the scene.
I swear to God, I'm gonna fucking kill him. No way. You need to question him. You know.
No way. Not if I do it first.
I'm gonna fucking kill him. Now I don't know.
You had plenty of time to get over.
You would think. Man, man. I didn't say that.
What in the heck?
You're in New York.
Yeah, driving up hills and around hills like they're in San Francisco.
Chris Hill's in New York.
Death of a mailman.
Hash the
mailbox. Yes! You got me!
And the guy's dead.
Might be dead. That's why you always wear your seatbelt. AJ's dad.
After him dies a blow, don't let him get away. You got it.
Okay, crash through the windshield. He's all right.
You
no blood.
My fucking lawyer will get you.
Fucking dumbass.
Better people tried.
What kind of music was that?
90s
music. Mad Bull.
Not the kid.
the matter, lawman? Not so sure of your aim anymore, huh?
Somebody's going crazy on that synthesizer. Just going back and forth.
I know. That's why I said, what the fuck's wrong with that music? Get away from my baby!
Hey, miss, come back! He's dangerous! Hey, get away from them, miss! You're putting yourself in great danger!
Please, just let the child go. Take me as your hostage instead.
She's a cop.
Look, I'm unarmed.
She's gonna disarm.
Hey, sexy
lady.
Won't you release the child?
Okay, it's a deal. But first, I gotta frisk you.
Obviously.
I mean, of course. What else would you do in this situation?
You and me, baby, me, nothing but animal.
Okay.
This really could have gone dark if you would have just shot the kid.
Right? Let the kid go. Okay.
Stop that, you bastard!
He's like, I'm gonna die.
Accidentally shoots her.
Just in the middle of the park.
shoots his leg.
Shoots himself in the dick.
Shoots her first, and then shoots him.
Oh!
Huh? And I'm so hardy, bubbling from the mouth.
Oh!
Did you hear that kid? Wow.
You can arrest him now, officer.
Yeah, I will, thanks.
Hey, Dysaburo! Well done.
I thought that was the kid in the background for a second.
It's her.
Oh, yeah. He was in disguise as that kid the whole time.
Right?
Oh my god, it's Perrine! Detective Perrine Valley!
So,
that gun was in her valley.
Sleepy?
What brings you out here, Perrine?
I've just been transferred from Queens. This is my first day on duty in the 34th Precinct.
I'll be damned. Dysaburo! Let me introduce you to Detective Perrine Valley, formerly of the Queens PD.
What? You mean that she's a police officer?
A woman police officer in the 90s?
He's my new partner.
Nice to meet you.
How common.
Look at him.
Well, I know where this is going.
Lonely Island's like, and I jizzed in my pants.
What's wrong, Dysaburo? You okay?
They haven't arrested that guy yet.
No,
he waves and he looks down and sees his dick.
This is a giant erection.
Oh, I thought he got shot.
I'm sorry about that, Sleepy. She had me standing at attention.
Bad Bull Part 2.
Wait. What? So is this technically a movie?
Manhattan Connection.
Yeah, so is this technically a movie or just like a mini series?
They're OVAs.
It's better than Asian Persuasion.
You've got a good grade knowledge of the principles of Qi Wu Kung Fu, and you're also a master of Kendo.
Kung Fu, wow. Karate, and Kendo. Master of all.
You're most welcome here at the 34th, and I'm sure I won't have to keep getting you out of trouble like some people around here.
Are you talking to me?
You talking about me? Talking about Mad Bull?
That guy's not a rapist, is he?
I was wondering where you'd
that guy doesn't look like the bad guy.
He's a dirty cop. Lieutenant DeMeyer.
How'd you do?
You have
he said, I admire your ass.
It's nice to meet you.
That
would
voice
you like
sounds
to
like it's coming out of that guy.
Yeah. Would you like to come back to my castle where I feed on those nights?
No, his name's Octopussy.
James Bond.
Nice.
It's a robot man.
What, Scar? Is that his name?
Listen, you sad shit.
Claw. Yeah.
Tell us where your suppliers are. I'll break your fucking neck, dickweed. Tell us.
Hey, Sleepy, take it easy, will ya?
Good cop, bad cop.
He is taking it easy, otherwise you wouldn't be able to fit between the two of them.
Tell you what,
he is taking it easy, otherwise you'd be scraping brains off.
You cocksucker, don't use your filthy fucking squawk with her. What? Your fucking mouth.
Hey, you don't use that fucking tone with her.
Like that. Let me do it.
You'll never get anything out of him like that. Grabs him. You motherfucker!
Burns him with a cigar.
I think you and I should take a trip in a squad car down to your son's school.
Wow, that's a good threat.
Then we could have a nice little stroll around the grounds. I wonder what your kid and his pals would think seeing you trussed up in these bracelets.
No, don't do that. My kid ain't got nothing to do with this business.
No, but it'd be educational for him to see what a loser his old man is. Everyone at Noyer's drug pusher. All his friends at Noah's dad.
Look at all these. They're like, oh my god.
But that's brutal. If he didn't say one cuss word.
Right, like they're got him by the fucking collar. Like, we're gonna fucking kill you.
Yeah.
And he walks like, in and just talks to him.
He walks in.
Walks in and says, we'll show your kid that you're a drug dealer. And they're like, what a scumbag.
He walked in and interrogated him like Batman.
They looked so disgusted in each other. They're like, what the fuck?
And now we're on the docks.
We're going to get you to talk with some cement shoes.
On the
I can't walk in cement shoes. They make my feet break out.
Okay, now here's the plan. Marine and I are going
like, you can't swim neither.
We'll play the part of a car.
I can swim pretty good. It's just
meanwhile, you two guys will keep watching the proceedings from your vantage point up there.
It's Vernon Heights.
So they're going to make the drug
deal. Well, go on. Get up there.
Yes, Lieutenant.
Lieutenant.
That was really long.
The mouth was open for that long. They had to fill the slot.
Fuck me, but it's cold up here.
Fuck me, but it's cold up here?
Kareem's a bastard. What's the deal? Am I gonna marry?
I swear to God, if he so much as touches her.
The man
is
cold.
I can always turn the heater on if you like. But the sound of the engine might attract attention. The best way to keep warm in these situations is to share our body.
What the hell are you doing?
Hey, shut up or you'll blow our cover, you stupid little bitch. I know you want me to put my cock inside you.
Cork. Cork.
Who talks like this?
I know you want me to put my cork inside you.
God, I can't stand it anymore. They're giving us the signal.
What?
Dad, I knew it.
Hey, look.
Dad, I knew it too.
He gave him the signal on accident.
Yeah.
And did you notice that a second ago they were just headlights, there was no car?
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
I thought that was weird.
In the 90s, man. That's what it's all about.
Yeah, the people who made that, they were like, yeah, we'll make it look like they're really small, so you can't see them.
We'll add the cars in post, don't worry about it.
Wait, why does he have a ripped pair of jeans?
Why does he got a ripped pair?
Yeah, that's a good question.
It's called style.
What the hell was that? Hey, look up there! The fucking cops! Kill him!
Fucking smile on his face.
He's like, if they're dead, I can get more.
I think Maple's gonna solve this situation.
Tell you what, I'm glad I wore my bulletproof vest tonight.
Oh! Couple shots in the ass.
Come on.
This is an excellent opportunity for us, Bree. While they're preoccupied, we can move in and seize the drugs.
While they're killing our friends, we can steal their drugs.
We'll call for backup and make the arrests. We'll have all the evidence we need to get convictions.
He's gonna rape her.
I can't trust my son.
But surely we should try and help the other two.
Fuck with them, they're just a couple of beat cops, they're expendable.
And so are you, Miss Valley, so just shut the fuck up and follow orders.
I'd just shoot him in the fucking face.
Remember when you said he was a dirty cop?
He is a dirty cop.
I'm starting to think you're right.
Get me covered.
Nobody with that face is a good guy. Except for what's his name from,
look out behind us!
Corridor. My character. He has that kind of face.
So did you see what he did there?
He created a version so he could get away.
He stole the drugs and then alerted them to her so that they'll kill all three of them. What's Madville gonna do? He's got grenades taped to his dick hair.
That is hilarious.
What'd you say this was called?
Mad Bull.
No.
Man-a-man.
Yeah, there we go.
I use these grenades for a jock strap. For a jock strap? Oh,
God. You imagine getting shot in the dick? Did you see that? He pulled it off and then ripped the hair out.
He's crying. He's crying.
Oh,
that's
fucking... Oh, God.
Did you see that one dude's eyes?
Oh, shit.
Is there anything left?
Man, okay.
Yeah. Give me one of those points.
I need to fucking have.
He's like, whoa. Wait, were you going to acknowledge the fact that this dude got shot 6 times in the ass?
Lieutenant DeMeyer, the 34th Precinct's greatest hero. Goddamn horseshit. He's even received a friggin' commendation from the department. What a bunch of crap.
Yeah. Maya didn't do shit, he just ran away.
He does not have that big of an ass.
It's called a cast.
Right.
The ice would not be helpful then.
I don't know, man. Man-a-man.
Good news, gentlemen. The New York Police Department has finally destroyed the Golos cartel once and for all. That leaves the way open for our organization to step in. Next week we will take delivery of the largest shipment of narcotics.
No, 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 no,
before that, there is some business we must take care of. I will have my revenge on the woman who put me in his chair.
Oops.
Oh, he's dead.
It might be.
Oh.
The woman's name is Peppy Valley, and she must die before next week's delivery.
Did you hear that? He said he wants revenge on the woman who put her put him in this chair, and just happens to be the new detective.
And this woman will pay with her life.
Goes to her is super in love with. And because of that drug bust that just happened, the car, whatever cartel he said, is completely out of the picture, and they're going to take over.
Mm-hmm. Look at that fucking clip.
I feel like...
It's illegal.
Extended mags are illegal, right?
They are.
Not in the 90s when you're a cop. Look at that weird ass sandwich.
And like, you sure do love mustard.
And it turns out she's the dirty cop.
No. Wouldn't that be some shit?
Yeah, that would be completely out of nowhere. I'd be like, what?
This man is love struck.
Give it to him.
These are for you.
They're very nice, but really a good one.
Take them.
What, Sleepy? I don't understand. What are you giving me a bouquet of flowers for?
Moron, these flowers aren't supposed to be for you. You should give them to her.
Eh?
I don't know who you're talking about, Sleepy.
I can read you like a book. You've got the hearts to read.
What? It's nothing like that.
You're just flopping around like a dork doing nothing.
Flopping around like a dork doing nothing.
A girl like that would be wasted on me.
Don't be so stupid. If you're in love with a girl, you have to do something. You got that?
But.
It's a scientifically proven fact that all women like to receive flowers. So go and give it a damn thing. Scram.
I like his idea of science.
Man, man.
Yeah. It's like everybody's thoughts of today's version of science.
Sleepy, pretty cool dude.
And of course, he's just gonna
stay. She's getting laid with someone else.
He's just so nervous.
Just because we've eliminated the gold car cartel's operation doesn't mean we put an end to drug trafficking. I'm giving you evidence of the existence of another organization and you won't even look into it. What's going on?
For a detective, you have a very active imagination, Miss Valley. There really aren't any more drug cartels.
There you go.
Now I suggest you forget
There's
it.
No more drugs in the city.
More useful.
We solved crime.
Yeah, crime does not exist anymore, except for those guys that keep robbing that store. But
see you around.
That's what the beat cops are for. Looks like he's, I know it's like a unibrow, but it kind of looks like he's got a giant scar across his forehead, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Him?
Yeah.
Actually, it is Scar.
No, there are. Oh, no, there are Scar. That's fucking weird. That's what you get for being a beat cop. I'm a detective.
John McClane was in there.
Well, detect this, bitch!
Yet. Oh, Guy Zaboro, what you doing out here?
I'm not doing anything.
Didn't even give him to her, did he?
How could he?
Rico?
If I remember right, he used to be a big crack baron down in Astoria, in Queens.
That's right. He was the mastermind behind the largest drug smuggling syndicate over there.
And you think he may be trying to set up a new organization here in Manhattan?
So the 34th priest, look at that motherfucker.
But I thought the scenario was
he could be eating the napkin.
That would be hilarious. You know you're not eating food.
He's like, yeah.
Now we're getting a flashback.
Oh, she's going to blow half his head off with a gun.
That guy got booked.
Okay, well, that was a shotgun.
That's what I said.
It's like she's Lady Bull.
Yeah. She's semi-angry.
Now you think he's already out of
Manhattan. Well, like I said, it's only a hunch, but it will be just Enrico style.
Yeah, so what's the Maya's reason for not looking into it then?
You mean she's a mad heifer?
He's up to something.
Sure.
Instead of a bull?
Yeah.
Hey, I gotta know. How did the flowers go down, huh?
On the floor and stepped on? Oh, that hurt?
Oh, no.
You know how fucked up that would be?
Pretty fucked up.
Oh, sleepy fuck. Oh, yeah. Give it to me really hard. Oh.
I often wonder when actors have to go in. Yeah, I've been wondering when actors go in and do this and they don't know anything about the material, and then they start reading and they're like, wait, what?
Yeah, and Sleepy don't have to say shit. He just got to sit there. Wait, did that cop star say police? They had no E for police.
I'm looking at it. Well, it's like, you ever watch the English dub of Bible Black? They're all foreigners. None of them speak English as their first language, and you can tell. And they're doing the English dub. It's really
the Japanese bad. Are doing the English?
No. It's just a bunch of people who don't speak English as a first language doing that for the English dub. So he left Sleepy, he's fucking his prostitute to follow that guy. So he's by himself.
Well, I mean, obviously.
He was filming AJ and he was looking at me while I was telling him. So. He got caught, AJ.
Yep.
He is a tiny, tiny man. Like, how tall do you think he is?
4'9".
I mean, Enrico's still alive? I knew he didn't die.
Yeah, well, Matt Wall's like, what, 6 foot, theory, 7 foot?
I look into it myself. Yeah. And I
I'd say he's like 6'6 or something.
Informant of mine told me where
I'm gonna say he's 7 feet tall, 320 pounds. The big red machine. A big blue machine.
This is where she'll find him. He'll
Kane's
find
not
her.
Actually 7 feet tall. He just wears platform shoes.
Yep.
He's what, 6 foot six?
No, I'd say he's like 6 foot.
That would be
he's like 6'10". He's like real close.
Because Undertaker is actually 6'10" too.
Can you imagine going to shake your mayor's hand and having to break your neck to look up?
It was a trap so he could get with her.
This man's dirty. Police commissioner?
First of all, y'all should have split up.
He's like a supervisor or something. Like, he's above all of them.
He could be a senior detective.
Maybe.
Like, somebody that's been there for a long time or something.
They look exactly the same.
But we know they're not the same person.
Manime.
I think we know now why he
he looks so bored. He's like, come on. Is it over yet?
He said Perrine.
You bastard! So, the reason you went into it was because you were too busy thinking of some other woman. Huh? I'll show you. You get out of my apartment, you pig. Go on, get out.
Now, where the hell's Dysapur?
They're he said gonna he have, looked like he wasn't into it, and it's because he wasn't.
They're going to have him up
he
there.
He was thinking of another woman?
Yeah, he's thinking about her.
They're going to have him up
not
there.
Not in terms
then,
of fucking, just like, he's worried about her or something. You recognize this place, AJ?
Yeah, it's where they had that meeting.
Yeah.
Crushed that glass.
This time I was expecting you.
Shoot him!
Now that's ominous. Do you think he's the bad guy? I'm not convinced, personally.
They got Dizaboro in the thing. It's not really him. She's gonna shoot him by accident.
Wait, how the fuck did he find the car?
He ran. There.
Coffee and piss. Long time no see, Sleepy. You haven't changed. You're looking good.
Nickel, a mechanic. You haven't changed either. You still stink of stale coffee and piss and you look like shit.
Well, you know me, Sleepy. I've always been a sucker for coffee with sugar.
What?
Nice. Now, pleasant as this is, I guess we ought to talk business. Word on the street says you flatfoots are investigating Don Enrico.
Oh, yeah? Who gave you that information?
Oh, just a little bird. Anyway, listen up. I want to cut you in on a deal. I want to try out my new brand of coffee on you. It's real refreshing. In exchange, I'll tell you where your partner went to. And I'll also tell you what's happening to your girlfriend, Perrine, at the moment.
What? What the hell are you saying, Nickel?
Agent!
Whoa!
Nickel?
I know. Well, that was really close.
First of all, you and I are going to play a little game together. If you win, then I'll tell you everything you want to know. All you have to do is just...
This looks like a man who likes to play games.
But I put plastic explosives in half the cans.
Depends on what day it is.
If you open the wrong can, it'll turn you into ground beef, and you have no way of telling
half the cans are
which.
Bombs.
If you're lucky and you come out alive, I'll tell you where your partner and the lady cop are. Well, Sleepy, how about it? There's a 50-50 chance.
Sorry, I'm pretty sure he's done a lot of method.
Go on.
Why?
Because
he's
you
missing teeth? That's stereotyping, and I don't approve.
It's stereotyping, but it's mostly true.
Oh, here's one. Tell me you ain't got your ass. Hey,
Don, I really
want him to talk like the guy from Family Guy that's in the wheelchair.
What's the matter?
He doesn't move his mouth.
Yeah.
So you're still alive.
Hey, Stephen Hawking.
He's telepathic. He's the only person in the world. It would have been better for you if I was.
Oh no, the obvious dirty cop was dirty.
Yeah, should. Don Enrico paid better than the police department.
You see, if you want the top people, you have to pay top money. Lieutenant DeMaia is a very useful man. He fooled you and your half-wit colleagues. Now, Miss Valley, you will pay for your stupidity.
Put me down, you bastard! Let me go, you asshole!
Dizaboro! Not you as well, Perrine.
I regret that we don't have time for a
I thought they were, like, mastering, like, art, martial arts or something.
Get up!
He's tied up. What do you want him to do?
There goes our danger.
How did I know they were going to do that?
Because
MANime.
This has nothing to do with me. Okay, it has a little bit to do with me. MANime gets weird sometimes.
He's just now getting to it.
Oh my god, how long does it take you to get on the other side of a vehicle?
Well, now, you want to play?
I would kind of hope that this is all happening like before that happens, like in a separate time
right.
thing.
So he can make it there in time?
Yeah.
Right. Hey,
I'll play.
Fine, he'll have no
cover. He's just standing there, and the only thing that protected him was his grenade crotch.
Like, he's just standing there, but now his shirt's gone.
Yeah.
Now I'm really angry.
She knows martial arts too. That's the whole reason they even, like, brought her in.
Right. But you can know martial arts all you want. I mean, you got four people holding every single one.
Well, he hasn't actually done it yet. I don't think.
I mean, he could have just done zip. I mean, I feel like when they
is this Kane from Mortal Kombat? Kano? Or was Cage?
No, it's Kane.
No shit! What?
Fire extinguisher. My sunglasses didn't protect my eyes! Wait a minute.
It's so smeary!
Squeeze him too hard.
Oh, he took some of those explosives with him.
Hey? You want some coffee?
Dizaburo! Hurry! Where are you? Hey, where's my partner?
God damn.
Either he or Marina, I heard you're gonna be in deep shit.
Wait, what? I thought he got shot.
Who? Yeah, he got shot. But
man,
he's wearing a, I think
you
he's wearing
a, worry about
he's
shit.
He's wearing a vest.
Bullshit.
He got blown up by plastic explosives in his bare hand and he's fine. You think a bullet's gonna stop him? Awesome. Think about it.
One of them actually was coffee.
And now they're good. Ged. I said Ged instead of
Ged. Don't worry. I know you must feel rotten, but I've seen worse.
Die! Hey, he took a bullet to the ass earlier, and now he's taking to the legs. And he's dead now. Assume that he would make it.
Oh, this is gonna be great.
I'm surprised he could even open his eye, you know what I mean?
Oh.
It's okay, the theme song's playing.
Please, sir, you'll do it. It'll make all the difference in the world to him, I know.
Mezaburo saved my life back in Enrico's place. So if there's anything I can do for him, I guess I should.
But getting married?
Mike, isn't it?
Fucking 90s.
Partner Mike died in the line of duty.
Man, oh man.
I can't forget him.
There's an excuse to start wearing thinners.
No shit.
Not the most politically correct shit.
I know, it was never PC, right?
What, this? I think it's perfectly politically correct.
So it's PPC?
Yeah.
What do you
think
he's doing?
No.
No. Giggity.
What?
No.
He just
pretend
to marry him
and
help.
What do you think Mike would have done if he was in the same situation? Tend to marry him so you can fuck him to make him happy. That's so fucked up.
It's a little fucked up.
Really?
That doesn't help anything. Oh.
Now, isn't that a beautiful
okay.
ceremony?
I didn't realize it was wedding music. I was like, oh.
The old, he's the 90% of his body was filled with contusions. Guess what wasn't? His penis.
Just this is a lovely ceremony, don't
you
think?
See how beautiful she is in a wedding dress?
How did they even get one so hard?
Kareem Valley, do you take this man, Diazaboro, to be your husband, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and cherish and obey, as long as you both shall live?
They don't say that obey part anymore, do they?
No.
Yes.
Yeah, they do.
Yes, I do.
I don't think they say it
yeah.
in like court.
Hey, no! The groom's nearly dead, Doc, and he deserves at least one kiss from the bride. And who knows, if we give him something to live for, he might even recover. And that's what he's supposed to be in a hospital for, isn't it? A doctor!
Where'd they get the ring so fast?
MANime.
George store.
God,
yeah, that's probably better answer.
Yeah.
Same place I got the wedding dress.
MANime!
Sad
so,
bull.
I don't
know he's not sad, he's glad bull.
Yeah.
Happy bull.
Happy bull.
Red bull.
Uh oh.
Gives you wings.
It's painted again hard.
Ah, that's just incredible.
His heartbeat spiked.
What's happened? A miracle. His heartbeat's getting stronger.
Oh my
and
god.
And everything.
Wait, no, wait. The blood's not going to his brain anymore.
Wow, that's great!
She's like, oh no, what did I do? I ruined my life.
Yeah! Ooh, what a fucking
right.
Oh my god.
This is a hospital! Yeah, right!
He just drops him.
Still one more thing we gotta do.
They go catch a detective.
This is Lieutenant DeMeyer. I'm flying to LA on an emergency case. I need a chopper. I make it snappy.
He stole the drugs and the money.
He's flying to LA on an important case.
With drugs and
with
money.
Two important cases.
Yeah, I'm flying to LA with drugs. I mean, two important cases.
Lieutenant
crap.
DeMeyer from the 34th precinct.
They open the door, he shoots and gets shot.
Ready for my departure.
Yes, sir.
That would have been funny, but the door was already
out. Oh, he's
okay,
flying.
Let's go. I'm in a hurry.
Right,
sir.
How'd they get there so fast? Man.
Oh, by the way, sir, I'm afraid I'll have to drop you off at the jail.
Oh, my God, it's you.
The case contains all the drugs you stole from Enrico's hideout. You fuck.
Hold it. Just do what we say, Lieutenant.
This is my wedding day.
Arrested in a wedding.
He's like, this is my wedding day.
You know better than to think you stood a chance of getting away with this, Lieutenant.
We all make mistakes, and you're right about the drugs. Hey, do you want to take a look at him? Here.
Why'd you even let him open it? The fuck is wrong with you?
And they weren't high enough for it to matter.
It would have been great if he would have broke his leg and then tried to limp away.
Yeah, where was all that skill when you were getting surrounded, you dumb bitch?
Well, I mean...
No.
They had guns.
Not only that, those were really big guys.
And he had a gun to their head.
Pretty soon I'm going to send him to play his harp with the heavenly choir.
He wants to kill Mad Bull.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, look.
See, I'm really recovering.
I can master.
Now you're gonna have teeth again.
He's like, no, I can master.
I don't mind telling you, we were getting kind of worried back there.
Kareem.
Yes.
I know that we just got married, but I think I ought to give you this ring back.
Oh.
I have my own dreams of a proper wedding. In a church with all our family and friends. And after, I want to be able to carry you over the threshold. Yeah? So until we decide to do it all for real, I'll have to give you this back, okay? So please, will you take care of it until then?
Married and divorced in the same
but at the same, but at the same time, it's like, he automatically assumes he's going to be with her.
Yeah.
Man,
it looks like she's fine with that. He's gonna make.
They winked at her.
He's
That's
gonna,
how you know.
He's gonna make her a moderately happy man.
What?
What? I messed that up.
Oh, he's crying.
Do I have to be classy or something?
Glad bowl.
Ow!
Oh, you fucking bastard!
You fucking bastard!
Oh,
and then it shows after the credits, she throws it over a bridge.
There you go. That's Mad Bull episode
so
2.
I actually like this one better than the first
yeah,
one.
This one's better, but what the fuck, dude?
It's got a jockstrap of fucking grenades and shit.
Yeah.
God.
He's pulling him off there, and he's like,
ooh.
This episode was crazy.
Yeah.
He fucking hung him up and used him like a goddamn speed bag.
Yeah.
Just beat the shit out of him.
Knocked all of his teeth out, and then you go into the hospital, and he's got
the luckiest again. Guy ever. He even got married.
And divorced in the same month.
Yeah, he didn't even have to deal with her bullshit. No.
You think she's still going to take half his stuff?
Oh, God.
That's mean. Man-a-man.
Like, share, subscribe. There's like nothing you can say.
Wait, what do you think's gonna happen next episode?
I don't know. That one dude's gonna try to kill him with coffee again.
Yeah, the coffee killer. And he's like, here you go. And it's real coffee. He's like, oh.
He's like, I use my own grind.
The man smells like stale coffee.
And piss. Yeah. Maybe that's what his coffee tastes like. Piss.
Oh, I was gonna say, his coffee tastes like coffee?
Piss. I thought it was hilarious.
Coffee
he's
piss.
Like, he's like, then let's do it! And pulls the thing and he just blows up. It's like, well, that...
And then he's just standing there with his shirt messed up.
He basically stood there like Goku about to scream.
He basically took C4 to the face and was like,
came out
you ruined my jacket, asshole.
Yeah.
You know, it makes you wonder how many uniforms he goes through in a month?
How many cars do they go through a month?
Did something happen to them? Oh, that explosion
took
it out.
Both their cars. They wrecked their car in the last episode and this episode.
Yeah.
Did they?
Yeah.
I remember him taking it
and
going
look,
to that warehouse.
This show.
No, they crashed in the very first guy.
Here's the thing, though.
Oh, that's right.
Like,
yeah.
This show, I can't actually like say anything about it. You know, it's not something that you will talk about over and over and over again.
Right.
But it's funny. You know,
it's
in the moment,
experience.
It's an experience.
Right.
You said experience.
Did I?
Yes.
This is probably one of the best animes right next to Dragon Ball Z.
Yeah, no.
In Japan. No.
But yeah.
Yeah, I completely agree. This is not a show that I've thought about.
No.
After I finished watching it the first time. And then I was actually just looking through my anime stuff and I was like, Mad Bull? That'd be a good thing to watch because it's just so fucking stupid.
It's so hardcore explosion action.
Before.
In
time
than one
is
more.
The thing? Because it's 7:30.
We can get through one.
Alright.
It'll be 8:30.
And then we can get the...
Go get that and then pod.
Okay. We're not going to watch the last episode.
We'll get to. Not until Monday.
Monday?
Are we hanging
or
out?
Tuesday.
What day are we actually hanging out again?
Yeah, let's not talk about that on camera. Alright, that was Mad Bull episode 2. Maname, motherfucker. Don't forget to check out our podcast.
We'll motherfucking Maname!
I might make that the title too.
Maname, motherfucker.
The first one will just be, huh?
You can't call it motherfucker.
I'll censor it.
No, MUFKA.
Exactly.
Wait.
I don't know. Tune in next time for episode 3. There's only 4 episodes of the show, and it's gonna get crazy.
That's why the asterisk is exists.
And remember, Bitch titties.
Hashtag titties.
All right. Man, I'm mad.